Hi everyone, I'm Ricky from Tech Talk, and today I want to go through the accessibility features on the Huawei P Smart. So massive thank you to Vodafone who has supplied this model for me to review and test out, and this is one of my favourite videos I like to do. As you all may know or may not know is that I'm actually registered blind, so I need to change these settings so I can use the device the best way possible for myself. Then I also like to show this video as well for people out there that also have another disability that they can use these great smartphones. So for this what we need to do is unlock your device, which I've already done. If we swipe to the right hand side here, you're going to see settings. What you need to do is jump into settings. So once you're in your settings, there's one option that I just want to show you that you can change in a different location, and that's if you click on display, you can change your text size here. So I've got it on the largest text size possible, but that one setting isn't in accessibility. Once in settings, you'll need to find another option called systems, which is right down here at the bottom. So tap on system, then in system you're going to see accessibility. So we have accessibility here. So in accessibility we have a full range of settings that we can go through and change. So at the top we have Talkback. So if we click on Talkback, Talkback is a great feature that will read everything you highlight on your device. What I'm going to do is just toggle this on. So once I highlight something, it will read everything to me.
When Talkback is on, your device provides spoken feedback to help visually impaired users. For example, it describes what you touch, select, and activate.
So what it does is describe everything that I've highlighted there in that box. I can highlight different things all around the device, and this will work even in your icons up here at the top.
1021.
You can scroll.
NFC enabled, 4G phone signal full.
So you get to hear everything that you want to, and this will work throughout your device, and it's a great feature for people that have low vision. But it's nice and easy and simple to use to actually make an action happen. Highlight, double tap.
Alert, stop, talk back. Okay, but
highlight,
double tap back off.
There we go, double tap, and that will take you off. With the impressive power and performance in this device as well, it runs very smooth and very easy to use. That's very nice that that feature is on here. So underneath that, we have a different style system, which is a selector speech. So if we go in here and then toggle this on, you'll get a new little icon down here at the bottom, which is a little accessibility man. If we click this and then press play.
Select to speak, help. When select to speak is on, you can tap specific item.
And as it says there, it will highlight specific items. So then we can activate again and then just press here.
Select to speak.
It just does that one simple thing. So you could press that play to read through a whole email, a text message, or your menu systems if you need that, which I think is a great feature also that they have included here. You have switch access, which gives you options to use switches with your device. Underneath that, we have captions. So if I go into captions here, so this is for subtitles and people with hearing impairment that you can have captions on videos, which I think is absolutely great. You then have magnification gestures. So if we go into here, once toggled on, three quick taps will enlarge your whole display. Use two fingers to move around. You can also pinch in to zoom as well. And as you can see from this display here, with their full view technology that Huawei use here, their text just looks absolutely brilliant. So one, two, three, back again. You can also do this a different way as well. So you, one, two, and then on your third, it's just hold the finger down, then move around the display. Once released, that will take the zoom back off. That's a great feature to see there. So you also have click after cursor stops moving, so you can use a cursor with this. And you have high contrast text. So if I toggle this on, it makes it a little bit bolder, a little bit more easier to read. The power button can end calls here. You can speak your password. You've got a large mouse pointer. You've got mono audio, accessibility shortcuts, so you can add a shortcut to get into these settings. If we go into here, I can talk about this. So what it's saying in here, when toggled on and when agreed to use, you can also do this on the lock screen, it will actually speak to you via TalkBack. And what you can do is press and hold the volume keys, both of them together, for 3 seconds. So we hold both of these. Here we go. We have a message about accessibility shortcuts come up there, and you can do this anywhere on your device. So that's also another great feature there. We have text to speech output, touch and hold delay. So that's anyone that's having a bit of a shake or has dexterity issues, that you can have that on here to help. Then the final two options down here at the bottom, you have color inversions. Once click this on, you get a white text on a black background, makes it a lot easier to read, and we can toggle that off. But please note that will change the whole device colors. Then finally, we have color correction there for people that have issues seeing certain colors. So as you can see for this device and its beautiful screen, you do have a wide range of options there that you can use and make it more accessible to you and then your disability as well. If you do need any help, please drop a comment down below and I'll be more than happy to help. As always, as I am registered blind, I use the large text, I use the zoom, and I also use the talkback. So that feature features are great for me, and most devices do come with them, but some don't, so please bear that in mind. Thanks always for watching. Please give a like to the video as it does help. And if you are new to the Tech Talk channel, welcome. Please subscribe to stay up to date with all our latest videos, and also follow us on Instagram and Twitter. The links are in the description, and you'll also find a link for this device. From me, Ricky, I'll see you very soon. Bye for now.